Virgil Abloh's taking some time out, man. What do you call it? Wishing him all the best and all that malarkey. But this news broke, I think, last night. I saw it pop up. So I guess all of that hard work, all of that effort that he's been doing over the years has finally caught up with him. I think for the most part, there were a few people Let me just take it off the screen now. Maybe there are some people out there that are kind of rejoicing at the fact that he's kind of, you know, taking some time off, which is kind of, you know, if that's you, then you need to kind of give your head a wobble and you're an absolute sicko if that is the facts, but hopefully not. I think most people are appreciative of just the amount of what he's been able to do, but Virgil Abloh has decided to take some time off. He's not going to be attending any of the shows, I think, in Paris, right, for Off-White and Louis Vuitton. He's going to take a few months off to kind of, you know, rejig and then kind of get back, I guess, designing for Fall Winter 2020. Which kind of makes a lot more sense in general. But yeah, man, the hardest working man in fashion is finally caught up with him, and he finally decided to take some time off. An article here from Vogue that kind of details the whole experience. Endorses all the Virgil Abloh has taken a few months off and will not attend his Paris Off-White show. Virgil Abloh, the famously busy founder of Off-White and men's artistic director of Louis Vuitton, a guy who flies internationally 8 times a week, is officially slowing down. "I'm shifting gears," he told Vogue over the phone today from Chicago. In August, he explained he was having a harder time than usual, bouncing back from the overseas trip. "I was just tired, so I went to the doctor. Ultimately," he continued, "everything is fine, but the doctor told me this place, you've got yourself pushing your body to fly all these miles to do all these different projects is not good for your health." Abloh declined to go into specifics about his health issue, but did say that his doctors have advised him to not travel. "Essentially, I'm going to work from home for the next 3 months, and in large part, all my marketing events I'm cancelling. That includes public appearances with IKEA and Nike and participation in Vogue's 3rd annual Forces of Fashion Summit, as well as a November opening of exhibition Figures of Speech at the High Museum in Atlanta." So again, a really cool end to that kind of story, I think, in general, because, you know, it's not often that designers or celebrities or people of notoriety take on doctors' advice, right? You can hear what doctors say, but you just think, you know what, fuck it, you don't know what you're talking about, I need to just keep hustling. But again, I guess it's also an interesting situation to be in, because I think there is this assumption that I got this feeling, right, when he was really, not with him, let's say Ariana Huffington, right? Yeah, Ariana Huffington. This is the way it comes into. She really annoyed me when she put that book out about sleep, right? Because it was this lady that's a multi-billionaire or whatever much she's worth, essentially telling us commoners that in the secret to success, the secret to building your own Huffington Post is to sleep 8 hours a day, which is a bit disingenuous, right? Of course, she's not saying that. I'm kind of reducing her book to, you know, the lowest common denominator, but essentially there was a movement, I felt as if, like a couple of years ago, of all these really big icons and really big entrepreneurs and successful people coming out and telling us that 8 hours of sleep was the key to their success. No, the key to your success was working at relentless breakneck speed 24 hours a day, 7 days a week for 10 years straight without a break. And then when you reach that level that you wanted to, you started taking 8 hour naps because you can, right? You've got more people around you that can do the jobs that you are doing all on your own. You have minders, helpers, assistants, companies, you have structures, processes set up that are able allow you to kind of sleep for 8 hours. But when you're Virgil, when you're screen printing t-shirts, when you're printing 23s on the back of rugby flannels and flipping them for however much you're doing, when you're designing album covers, helping out Kanye, whatever it may be called, interning at Fendi, you need to work at the level that he's worked to get to Louis Vuitton. He couldn't have got to Louis Vuitton, he couldn't have got his brand Off-White to the level it's been to now without working this hard. Yes, it's kind of hit the wall, and he's kind of quote unquote Truman wall, and he's kind of recalibrate. But this isn't the time to kind of look at it and say, oh, you see, now the pressure of the industry means that people have to take more time. No, the industry is the industry, right? Karl Lagerfeld, one of our biggest icons, passed away, unfortunately, recently. And he was an absolute workhorse, talented, influential, mercurial talent, one in a generation. Yes, but at the heart of it, he worked hard until the very last day that he passed away. I think he's even got a story about his great grand being a ballerina. Was it his mum being a ballerina? And she kind of wanted, or a dancer. And someone said, oh, when will you retire? And she said, oh, I'll retire in my studio, right? Her dream was to kind of like kneel over and die in her studio while she's working, right? That was the actual dream. Like, I'm doing what I love. This isn't work. I want to die where I'm most at peace. So for Virgil to be in a position where he's finally having to hitch that wall, it makes sense. But it's also a bit of a cautionary tale for the youngsters coming up, because as much as people might rib on him for his designs being a bit reductive and a bit copy-pasty and not well done and whatever it may be called, you might not like him, you might like his personality, his people he hangs around with, you cannot deny that the only way to reach the level of success that he's reached within this short period of time too, because think about it, it's been a long, you know, he will say 10 years he's been in the game, he's done his hours, but essentially he's been able to blow or to be as successful as he's been into, what, maybe in the last 5 years, maybe in the last 6 years, that's kind of like to go from, you know, a well-known streetwear dude to the fucking leader of the new school in fashion, to make that kind of run and to achieve what he has to achieve, he's had to have done this. This was the natural end. This is what had to happen in order to get to that level. So again, it's a cautionary tale for those of you kids out there that are like, oh, I can do what Virgil does. Oh, he's not good. He's not talented. Okay, cool. Take his seat. Do that, right? Because I'm sure part of the reason why this also got stressful was all the collaborations. I think balancing Off-White and Louis Vuitton, you know, as a brand is difficult. Don't get me wrong. But then when you add on to the fact that he's like the master collaborator, right? Anyone who's anybody that he thinks is talented, he will want to associate himself with, make some cool products with, capture collection, whatever it may be called. That's probably what ran him down the ground. And then when you add on top of that, he's DJing, right? He fucking DJed at Coachella. He essentially did an entire summer residency in Ibiza, right? Which is, you know, you only have to listen to a couple of Resident Advisor exchanges to hear how difficult it is to DJ in Ibiza during the summer, right? How the toll it takes on you physically and mentally. This guy's designing for two big fashion houses, right? A storied and well regarded and, you know, a very prestigious job in Louis Vuitton, and also his own brand that he's also built up to this insane level. And on top of that, he's DJing, and on top of that, he's collaborating, like, and on top of that, he's giving speeches, he's organizing retrospective art exhibitions that he's going to take on tour. It's insane the amount of work he's done over the years. But again, I think it's the only way he would have been able to land this Louis Vuitton job was to do this. But also, for the industry overall, maybe it's a good thing too for the industry to say, you know what, how far are we willing to push our designers? How far are we going to take them? How far are we going to push them over the edge until they get reach a breaking break? They reach a point. They reach a breaking point. We have to realize. Look what happened to John Galliano. John Galliano essentially blamed that whole entire freak out with his weird anti-Semitic views when he was kind of being a bit, you know, a little bit nasty in that cafe in Paris. He blamed it because of fatigue, right? A bit of exhaustion, right? He got pushed to the brink. Hedi Slimane, right? Same sort of thing too. Like, how far do we want to push our designers? How far do we want to push these people? Because essentially, they are the ones, because like in all industries, right? There's the top 5% of people, or the top 1%, maybe top 5 or top 10% of designers out there who are really pushing it, who are really setting the tone for trends, fashion, whatever it may be called, right? They're the ones setting the pace. We need those people around. We need them. We don't need to be pushing them to the edge. So again, industry, will it take a hard look at itself and kind of change tack? Probably not. Because there's loads of designers out there who are more than willing to able to, you know, to work under their desk and ungodly hours and run himself into the ground. But, you know, after watching the Alexander McQueen documentary and just seeing how much he put himself through and what the industry did to him and what it turned him into, how he's affected his friends and family, I don't want to see that happen to anybody else. So if Virgil has to take some time off to relax and to get his mind back right, that's okay with me. And if it means he comes back and he's a whole different person and he's eschewing a different sort of mentality, a different sort of message, hopefully he doesn't come out and start talking about 8-hour sleeps and meditation. Hopefully he's able to tell people, look, if you want to be as successful as I am, right? Because I think people have weird delusions of grandeur about their level of ambition doesn't match their effort. I think Gary Vee talks about it a lot, right? You want to be a Virgil, but then you work 2 days a week. It's like, you can't do that. You have to be moving. You have to be moving as much as he is, or maybe more. So I feel hopefully when he comes back from this break, he's able to kind of delve into it and say, look, I reached a certain point in my career where I'm able to do all these things on my own and fly around and do it. But there has to be a point where he has to be able to rein it back in again. Because there are some people, some good critics actually, that were saying that that was part of the reason why some of his designs were kind of suffering and his collections weren't as good because of the DJing stuff, right? He was too distracted. Which makes sense, right? I think even in MMA, they say a lot, right? In MMA, they always say, like, you know, the moment the fighter starts appearing on TMZ and doing loads of media stuff and doing a podcast and just running around doing anything but training is a moment they're going to die. Because whilst you're out there, you know, out on TMZ talking about whatever happened in pop culture, your opponent is in the gym training, right? That's what they're doing. They're just on that heavy bag. Boom, 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 boom. So imagine in design, right? Or imagine in fashion, the same sort of thing in the creative field, right? Whilst you're swanning around at some sort of press junket, DJing in the middle of Ibiza, playing at Coachella, playing at Burning Man, doing a collaboration with IKEA. That kid, that designer, is at home just crafting, honing their craft, pattern cutting, stitching, putting stuff together, draping, finding ideas out for new lookbooks and new photos, editorials. They are expanding and honing their mind so that when it's game time, they're ready to go. So maybe that is part of the reason too. He needs to kind of, you know, and again, I'm pretty sure, you know, designers only have to take a week off, and then as soon as they come back, you see the amount of energy and the amount of new ideas they've got. So I can only imagine what 3 months is going to do. 3 months, he's going to come back on fire. So again, hope he gets well soon. Hope he's able to get back on his feet and things go well. And then, yeah, we see a completely different Virgil. We see maybe a more focused Virgil. We see a Virgil that maybe is able to kind of delegate a little bit better. But also see a Virgil that's able to tell the kids, look, if you want to be me, if you want to get a Louis Vuitton job, right, you have to do this. This is what you have to do. Now, you know, it might have cost him his sanity for the most part, but sacrifice has to be made, man. How bad do you really want it, right? That is it. It's all well and good getting the 10,000 hours in, but how bad do you really, really want it?